discovered the oldest house while investigating a suspected altered world event case. Once we became aware of it, the data was there. For the rest of the population, it was hiding in plain sight. A slippery blind spot, seemingly discouraging observation. It's a place of power. An ongoing AWE of its own. Seemingly adhering to its physical outer constraints, and yet constantly breaking the known boundaries of reality. It's unstable. Shifting. Note, for more details on control points and the research and process to stabilize and secure the core sectors, refer to a separate presentation. After extensive research and investigation, the Bureau made the building its headquarters on November 13th, 1968. The Federal Bureau of Control was never out in the open. This was always an obfuscated, classified, top-secret operation. So imagine our surprise when the building's observation-resistant aspects began in some unquantifiable way to affect the Bureau as a whole.
Yeah. not the best time for a tour. We have hiss everywhere, numerous cell breaches, and system failures across the board, but... You're the director, so here we go. Founded by Zachariah Trench, the Panopticon is our state-of-the-art repository for all altered items, objects, power, and...
I was told Dylan Faden was kept here. Can you help me find him?
Faden? Sure. Darling wanted him somewhere secure and isolated away from people. He's in the maximum security cells on her level. But there's currently a pressing matter, ma'am. We've got an object of power loose in there. It's wrecking the place. The Benikoff TV. It's a real doozy. Salvador took a team in to handle it, but no one's heard from them for hours. This is a Category 5 OOP we're talking about. If we don't contain it soon, it will tear the Panopticon apart. We don't want all those altered items getting loose, ma'am. Oh, trust me.
Open the door, Langston. I'll handle it.
If you say so. I usually tell first-timers not to touch anything, so, just do that. Here, I'll get the door for you. And please, ma'am, call me Fred.
Thanks, Langston.
I guess life's a breach, huh?